Hi everyone, this is Mary Gregory and welcome to our video for today. We're going to be talking about post-op complication care. I'm also going to be sharing some upcoming events that we'll be having. But first, let's talk about post-op complication care. When in coding, and you often may see this like on one of your tests on CCS or CDIP, your Clinical Documentation Improvement Practitioner test, or maybe even on the CPC. And definitely in the real world of coding, how do we handle post-op complications? According to the official coding guidelines, code assignment must be based on the provider documentation making the relationship between the condition and the procedure. A lot of times we have to decipher or know when a physician document, for example, post-op atrial fibrillation. What does that really mean to you as a coder? We know that we have a code that says cardiac complication following surgery or during surgery or result of the surgery. So when the physician document post-op atrial fib, we have to know if that physician is saying that the atrial fib is really due to the procedure, or is it a condition that is occurring in the postoperative period. Sometimes patients have conditions after they have surgery, but it has nothing to do with the surgery itself. So moving forward, if you want to code a post-op complication, make sure that the relationship is made between the condition and the relationship in your documentation. Now, there are going to be times when the condition itself will be understood to be a post-op complication. For instance, if a patient came in hemorrhaging out of their incision, well, we know that that's a post-op bleed because the incision where they made the cut is now bleeding. And a lot of times your physician will say post-op hemorrhage, and that is perfectly acceptable. So we as coder have to understand when we may need to query, when we may need to make that relationship. And also remember, you as a coder, you get paid to think. And it's our role as coders to know how to take our documentation and apply the rules and the guidelines to that documentation. And we don't want to bombard the physician with queries. Physicians are very busy. So only query when it's appropriate to do so. Maybe next week I'll go into the different suggestions from the query. We have a query paper that was put out by HEMA that tell us when we should query. And we really need to use that as our guideline and not bombard the physician with queries. So remember, if you're going to code a post-op complication or a post-op condition, make sure your documentation make that relationship between the condition and the procedure. I want to thank you for listening to me today. I want to talk to you also. I want to remind you about our classes that we have. We actually hold live classes here in Charlotte, North Carolina on different subjects. We have an online 101 class. That class is definitely for anyone that's looking to be a coder, or you just want to go back and learn some of the basics dealing with I-9 and CPT. We will be having a CDI, a two-day CDI workshop coming up in May, I do believe. We got a CCS prep coming in April. And I want to remind everyone, if you're in North Carolina, the North Carolina HEMA will be having a state meeting April the 21st through the 24th. So I just want to remind you of that. Also, remember to follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And always feel free to visit our site. Our website is www.mascodingsolutions.com. This is Mary Gregory signing off for today, and I want you to know coders get paid to think, and I look forward to talking to you real soon.